Hi, Theo from Apify here, and today I'm going to show you how to add custom actions to your GPTs with Apify Actors. You're probably aware that anyone can now build a GPT, but to build a really good one, you need custom actions. Why? Because they expand the functionalities beyond standard responses. They can include integrating APIs, accessing external databases, or even triggering events in other applications. So today, I'm going to take you through the whole process of building a GPT with a custom action from an Apify actor. In this case, we're going to use Screenshot Taker, which you can find on Apify Store, right here. To demonstrate the value of creating a GPT with custom actions, I'm going to show you the difference between using vanilla GPT-4, creating your own GPT without a custom action, and creating your own GPT with custom actions. I'm going to ask GPT-4 to take a screenshot of a website. It can't do it. So let's try with a GPT we created to take screenshots, but without a custom action from Apify's screenshot taker. And it still can't do it. Now let's try with a GPT we created with a custom action from screenshot taker. It works. The custom action from Apify's actor has given our GPT abilities it didn't have before. So now I'll show you the process of creating a GPT like this. You need a GPT Plus account, which costs $20 per month, and an Apify account. You can sign up here. Any plan, including the free one, will do. So let's start by going to GPT-4. On the left sidebar, click on Explore, then click Create GPT. Follow the prompts to provide your specifications. First, we need to state what the purpose of the GPT is. In our case, we just need to type something like a tool that takes screenshots of websites. It will then propose a name for the GPT, which you can accept or modify. It will do the same for an image for the GPT you're creating. Now you need to provide instructions for the GPT. You can tell it how to communicate with the user, things it should do or avoid doing, and so on. Now you have a basic GPT set up. If you don't want to do anything else with it, you can just publish it as is. But if you want to make it really useful and reliable, then you need to configure it by going to Configure. Here you can upload documents to act as a knowledge base. For example, if you have a PDF file with information for the GPT to refer to when it generates information, you can upload it here. But the real magic happens here in the Add Actions section. If you're going to use an Apify actor to give the GPT web scraping capabilities, you should first disable the web browsing capability to avoid interference of the native web browser with Google Search, for example. That's what we did when we built the Google Search Scraper GPT. If you want to build a similar one using a custom action from Apify's Google SERP Scraper, check out the tutorial in the description. In our case, we're going to use Screenshot Taker. So now we'll find that in Apify Console. Click on the Actor Detail page, hover over to the API tab, and select Export Open API Schema. Just click the copy icon in the corner. Then pop back to GPT and paste the schema into the Add Actions field. For the authentication part below, we need our Apify API token. So back to Apify Console. Click on the Settings, then Integrations. Simply copy your personal API token, then head back to GPT to edit the authentication field. Select API key for the authentication type, paste your API token underneath, and select Bearer for auth type. Now just one last step. You need to paste the Apify privacy policy in the box below. You can easily fetch that from our blog post on how to add custom actions to your GPTs. Now just click Save and Publish. We'll choose the Only People with a Link option, and we're done. So let's put it to the test. And there you have it. Couldn't be done with plain GPT-4, couldn't be done with a custom-built GPT without the custom action, but with Apify, we've given our GPT special powers. But before we end, I ought to point out that not every actor is suitable for what we demonstrated as a GPT action. OpenAI enforces a timeout of 45 seconds for the action to return a result. So the actor needs to be able to return its output in that time frame. Otherwise, users of the GPT will see timeout errors. For more information about GPT and actor limitations, check out that blog post I mentioned earlier. The link is in the description. So, now you know how it works. What custom actions will you add to your GPTs? We'd love to know what GPTs you've created with Apify Actors, so please post them in the comments for others to try out. Before you go, don't forget to give us a thumbs up, subscribe, and click that bell to keep up with future content. So long, and thanks for all the likes.